in the field of findings as far as your placement prospects are concerned. One of the subject is financial statement analysis. Unfortunately, students, they do not recognize it. I don't know what is the reason. But you should try to understand that most of the financial decisions are based on financial statement analysis only. Until unless we analyze financial statement, we won't be able to make good financial decisions. Until unless we understand the health of business enterprise, we will not be able to infer conclusion out of that. So from that point of view also, studying financial statement analysis is very important. Let's try to understand first what is financial statement. As we have been discussing earlier also, three words are there in financial statement analysis. There are two types of linkages, as we have been discussing in case of business policy: forward linkage and backward linkage. In most of the cases, we go with forward linkages, but sometimes it is equally important to go with backward linkages. The same approach I am following here. Financial statement analysis will be starting from analysis. So financial statement analysis is basically analysis of statement which contains financial information. Financial information are of different types. We can categorize them. As you see, the financial items could be classified into two different categories. One category which is related with the income and expense, whether we purchase something, whether we sell something. If it is related with merchandising, so of course the revenue and expense is likely to take place. The second category of financial items or financial variables are related to asset and liability of the enterprise. Without having assets, which arises out of liability, any business enterprise will not be able to start and run its operations smoothly. So all the financial variables usually falls in these two broad categories. One category is related with the income and expense, and the latter one is related with the asset and liability. So financial statement analysis, as I have told you earlier also, it is analysis of a statement which contains financial variables, financial information, or which are outcome of some of the activities which could fully or partially be measured into financial terms. So on the basis of nature, a statement could be categorized into two parts. Part 1 deals with those items which are related with the income and expense. So for income and expense, we are having a statement which is known as profit and loss account, popularly in case of an income. But if we see the global scenario, the most common name used for profit and loss account is income statement. However, you can use either of the name, whether it is profit and loss account or income statement. The second set of financial information are related with the asset and liability. And the statement which covers different financial variables which are related with the asset and liability of the enterprise, they are given in balance sheet. Again, balance sheet, this terminology is popularly used in case of Indian economy. But if you refer to global scenario, it is given as a statement of affairs or a statement of financial position. There is one more important financial statement, which is basically outcome of both the set of financial variables, be it income expense side, be it asset and liability side. And that statement is known as cash flow statement or statement of cash flow. Either of the terminology could be used. As you know, being a student of finance, interlinked with accounting, only those transactions, events, activities are undertaken which could be measured into monetary units. So everything which takes place in case of business organization that is related with finance and that has to be measured into monetary units. And when we talk about monetary units, ultimately we are talking about cash. So a lot of movement of cash takes place in the organization. So of course there will be two types of movement. One will be inward and other will be outward. So due to some activities we can experience outward movement of cash, which is also known as cash outflow. And some of the activities are there which results into cash inflow. So these are three main financial statements which is generally prepared. In addition to these three statements, some other statements will also be prepared. That is for analysis purpose. When we talk about income statement, so income statement contains all the information which are related directly or indirectly to generating revenue to the enterprise and incurring expenses for generating revenue. When we talk about statement of financial position, all the variables are either asset or liability of enterprise or exist in the form of capital. So sometimes people omit the word capital, they simply talk about asset and liability. Assets are acquired and the financing of asset is solely dependent on the capital use as well as due to liability. So these are two broad categories of finance. Now question arises, what are the objectives of financial statement analysis? Why one should go for financial statement analysis? If you are a businessman, you might be having your own visions. If you are a student, you might be having your own visions. As it is well known to all of us that there are different stakeholders of a business organization, right from owners, creditors, management itself, government, future investors, even employee of the enterprise, they all are interested in financial statement analysis so that they can know what is going on, how is financial health happening. However, in nutshell, the objectives of financial statement analysis could be studied into five points. The very first point which influence our financial statement analysis is assessment of past performance. Knowing your past, knowing our past, knowing past of the enterprise is very important. Because past provide a basis for future planning. So having deep understanding of past is necessary. When we talk about past performance, means we are talking about
last financial performance of the enterprise. So if we go with financial statement analysis, we'll be equipped with the information on past performance of the enterprise. On the basis of past performance, some decision could be taken by finance manager or the finance director of the enterprise. Those decisions may include even taking certain corrective measures to improve the performance. The second objective of financial statement analysis is assessment of current position. Once you have assessed the past, it is equally important to assess the current. What was and what is. Only then you will be able to assess your future, because there has to be a coherence in between your past, present. Only then you can plan the future. So it helps in assessing the current situation of enterprise. Then the third objective of financial statement analysis is prediction of profitability and growth prospects. Profitability is nothing but it is profit earning capacity of the enterprise. So profitability term is composed of two different terms. One is profit and there is ability. So ability to generate profit is basically known as profitability. So how much competent an enterprise is, how much efficient an enterprise is in generating the revenue to the enterprise is known as profitability. And secondly, growth prospects. So if you will be able to assess your growth prospects, so the only fundamental which helps you in assessing the growth prospect is financial statement. Bankruptcy and failure. Assessing the bankruptcy and failure. It could be one of the objectives of financial statement analysis. As you all are aware, that present scenario is very complex. We are working in very complex financial environment. The environment is very competitive. Information is freely available to everyone. Whoever is sincerely interested in having those information. So in absence of information gap, information is available to everyone. So you need to be competitive. Sometimes, some enterprises, they fail to do so. So there are chances of bankruptcy and failure also. Financial statement analysis is a weapon, it's a tool to assess and forecast whether business is sound or is it moving towards bankruptcy and failure. At different point of time, at different level, through financial statement analysis, financial expert will be able to infer conclusion whether the business could be saved or some other way. One very popular model is suggested by Professor Altman, a very leading economist. He gave a very fantastic model for prediction of bankruptcy and failure. Anyway, we'll be discussing it later. But understanding the situation of bankruptcy and failure is again one of the objectives of financial statement analysis. Operational efficiency is again a question of concern, and financial statement analysis can be done for assessing the operational efficiency of the enterprise. The enterprise may be sufficient enough it may have large quantity of acid. But whether enterprise is efficiently using those assets, whether they are really operating at the scale of operation required to operate, this could again be a question of concern. So financial performance analysis, financial statement analysis is done even to check operational efficiency. So these are the reasons, these are the motives. In nutshell, you can say objectives of financial statement analysis. Once we talk about financial statement analysis, the type of statements which I have described earlier, the income statement, the statement of financial position, and the cash flow statement. We talked about objectives of financial statement analysis. Then at the same moment of time, it is equally important to know about the different parties, the stakeholders who are interested in financial statement analysis. So think critically. Who may be interested in the activities of enterprise? Who may be interested in checking the financial performance of enterprise? You will have also the very first party which is interested in financial statement analysis is shareholder itself. Shareholders are the owners of enterprise, and owner always wishes to check the performance. And the tool which is used, that is financial statement analysis. Being owner, your main concern will be on earning, that how much earning enterprise is able to provide, whether enterprise health is sound or is it weak, as well as overall performance of enterprise. So shareholders are the major stakeholders who are interested in financial statement analysis. Apart from shareholders, investors and lenders, they are also interested in financial statement analysis. Investors are the persons who invest their hard money in the enterprise in the form of, maybe in the form of shareholding itself, maybe in some other form. Lenders are also there who provide loans to the enterprise. So this is a broad category only. You should try to understand that the person whoever is supplying finance to the enterprise will be interested in financial statement analysis. And the very obvious reason is to check in the credit worthiness of the enterprise. Whether enterprise is in position to service their debt, whether enterprise is in position to service their investment or not. So from that very viewpoint, they are interested in financial statement analysis. Then the third stakeholder, that is creditor, they are also interested in financial statement analysis. Of course, creditors are certain loan providers, but they have their mistake. And you should not be surprised to know that there are many enterprises which are more based on working capital rather than investment in fixed assets, specifically the service industry. So role of creditors, the importance of creditors cannot be omitted. So creditors are interested in financial statement analysis because they wanted to check the short-term solvency position of the enterprise. Whether enterprise will be able to meet their obligation within one accounting year or not. that what is there for itself. In addition to creditors, management itself is one of the major stakeholders who is always interested in financial statement analysis due to variety of reasons. Because management will have to check both the financial efficiency as well as operational efficiency of the enterprise. So whether it is financial or it is operational, ultimately it has to be quantified. And quantification is done through financial statements. So from control point of view also, from service point of view also, from employee satisfaction point of view also, from attracting future investors points of view also, management is always interested in financial statement analysis so that they can have a glimpse of overall financial performance of the enterprise. And if some corrective measures are required on the basis of statement analysis, that can be taken. Then finally, government. You know, the major source of revenue for any government is tax, especially corporate tax. A huge portion of total tax collection accounts from tax from companies, tax from corporates. So government also wishes to check financial statements so that they can see how much profit is generated by enterprise. Sometimes manipulations in financial statements also takes place. Manipulations in accounting records could also be observed. Government wanted to check whether the financial statements submitted with them is okay or not. Is it true or fair or not? So financial statement only provide a basis for levying taxes. So government is one of the major stakeholders of financial statement analysis. After different parties interested in financial statement analysis, now we can move to next section of our discussion, that is importance of financial statement analysis. Though it is intertwined, all the topics which we are discussing here, that is interrelated, some in the form of chapter, some in the form of interested parties. We can try to summarize it in the form of importance. So financial statement analysis plays a very crucial role in many of the activities, in many of the actions, in many of the decisions. The first category of statement of financial statement lies in holding of shares. Being a shareholder, being a valuable owner of the enterprise, you will always be interested into maximizing earning per share. Through financial statement analysis, you could try to visualize the real picture. There are different tools through which you can assess what was performance in past, what is performance today, and what is likely to occur in future. So you can decide upon your holding of shares on the basis of financial statement analysis. If you are a vigilant investor, if you are a vigilant shareholder, you will never be interested into deteriorating price of the shares. Because if the price of shares deteriorates, it will be having a severe impact on the total share. So in such a situation, you will not be interested to continue as a shareholder, as a owner of that particular entity. So your decision आप रिमेन बीइंग एज अ शेयर होल्डर इन दैट पर्टिकुलर कंपनी विल सोली बी डिपेंडेंट ऑन द एनालिसिस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट विच विल प्रोवाइड यू द आइडिया whether to continue with the same holding, or to increase holding, or to reduce holding, or to leave it completely. Secondly, the importance of financial statement analysis could be studied in the section of decisions and plans. So many decisions have to be made in the normal course of action of any enterprise. Again, I am repeating the same thing that everything has to be viewed in monetary terms only. Whatever action you take, whether it is qualitative or quantitative, that has to be measured into finally monetary units. So whatever decision you will take in the enterprise, that will be having impact on the basis of financial statement analysis. Now you can make decisions. Decisions may vary. It may be related with continuing with operation. It may be related with imports. It may be related with exports. It may be related with outsourcing. It may be related with introducing a new wing, it may be related with introducing a new range, it may be related with anything else related thereto. So whether it is make or buy decision, whether it is sell off decision, whether it is divestiture, whether it is merger acquisition, whether it is takeover, or whether it is related with routine activities of enterprises, say working capital management, the ultimate information you get through financial statement analysis only. And on the basis of data and interpretation of data, basically one can plan for the future. Then the third point which we can take here again, importance of financial statement analysis with extension of credit. As we all are knowing that present business environment is very complex, we are observing a very high degree of competition. So in order to be viable, in order to be sustainable in cutthroat competition, we need to offer credit services. Every time cash may not be available, so you will have to run your organization on credit basis also. So whether to extend credit facility or not, whether to enhance the time length of credit, again this decision will be dependent on financial statement analysis only, because it will provide you the idea whether you are in position to extend this or you should not go beyond this. Is there any need of curtailing this time framework? Are things related there? So extension of credit, this particular decision is based on financial statement analysis only. Investment decision, the most crucial decision being made by a finance manager, is again dependent on analysis of financial statement. Thousands of alternatives are available. I would say opportunities are available in the lower. But is this every opportunity be undertaken? No. We will have to see the feasibility. We'll have to see the capital, the fund available with us. will have to see the expansion requirement of business. We need to meet the expectation of shareholders. Finally, we need to address every stakeholder of the enterprise. So investment decision is very crucial, and financial statement analysis provide a broad framework for making good investments. I'm hopeful you are here with importance of financial statement analysis. So as there are many important points of financial statement analysis, there are certain limitations also attached there. Though limitations are not that much prominent as the importance is, but even one should understand it, one should keep it in mind at the time of doing financial statement analysis. The very first limitation of financial statement analysis is misleading the user. Sometimes user may not be in position to draw right conclusion out of financial statement analysis, because financial statements basically provides data, and decision based on data may not necessarily be always correct. If the data given in financial statement is not correct, it may mislead the investors. So we need to take caution . We need to check the authenticity. We need to validate whether the data, the information contained in financial statement, and the way of analysis is appropriate. So sometimes it is misleading to the users. Some people argue that it is not useful for them. Though it is not absolutely correct, but up to certain extent, of course, yes. Because future is unpredictable. What we do in case of financial statement analysis, we appraise the past performance, we see the current, and on the basis of past performance and current situation, we plan for future. But situation may be reversed in future. There may be a drastic change. So sometimes